Greetings, fellow Wolfens. Welcome back to Delta Force. Wait, let me take that from the top. Greetings, fellow Wolfens. Welcome back to Delta Force. Today's mission is the final mission of the Novaya Zemlya campaign, as well as the Delta Force game, and it is Operation Snow Fox. This is where we capture the nukes that the rebels have been threatening us with, and we pretty much just bring an end to their reign of terror on both the Russia and the United States, as well as the rest of the world as well. So yeah, this is the final mission of this game, and I think it might be a little bit of Stockholm syndrome working on me, and I think a little bit of the fact that this game was actually good. This game wasn't bad, actually. So, but anyway, I digress. These are all words for after the video is over, and let's get this mission. Let's just wait for the music to kick up. It didn't. I'm disappointed. I'm also disappointed. The music is supposed to kick up right there. Anyway, that actually seems like a very nicely structured map, with loads of enemies, with way too many enemies. But yeah, not a lot of terrain for us to hide behind either, apparently. And from the looks of it, one of our teams is going to, you know, die right off the bat, and I'm pretty sure we're gonna have to save the other team. This map actually reminds me of the final mission from the Indonesia campaign, which was a major pain in the ass. But anyway, mission: capture the supply base designated objective Nova, where the enemy is storing the nuclear weapons. Warheads, I was about to say warheads. And I suppose they are warheads. Because they are pretty much meant to be launched by a missile. Execution: Black Widow will insert you approximately 385 meters northeast of the objective Nova. Follow your pre-designated axis of advance closely as there is an enemy supply depot approximately 160 meters south of your ingress point. Okay, why am I being dropped that far out? I have no idea. You will enter objective Nova from the east. Radiation detector background counter analysis indicates the nuclear weapons are being held in a warehouse on the southwest corner of the complex. Take extreme care not to damage the weapons. Once you have secured the weapons, a nest team will be flown in to secure them. Okay. In order for this mission to be successful, you must eliminate all resistance at the objective. Alright. Okay, so basically we want the nukes for ourselves. I got it. Severe winter conditions continue to limit enemy patrols. Okay, but the weather conditions are suddenly severe for some reason. I have no idea why. Infrared photography shows that both the supply depot and the objective are heavily manned. Okay. All source intelligence indicates that both facilities are defended by experts in our special forces. Mercenaries, yeah. I mean, once you get out of the army, from what it seems, at least in the USA, from what I can tell from moving stuff, you either have two options: become a mercenary, actually three options, become a mercenary or try and find some honest living, or just, you know, this is the third option, you become an extremist. But yeah, sad, but that is how it tends to be. I mean, the more specialized you are in the military, the more your drive is to, you know, do something extreme, so to speak. But then again, that's just my observation. Allied support: Alpha team will insert approximately 145 meters northwest of the supply base. They will advance southeast and will conduct a diversionary attack on that facility in the supply. Charlie team is in position approximately 85 meters south of the ship Nova. They will attack northeast into the compound as you attack from the east. So basically, Alpha team will be the first to die. Unless, of course, Charlie team is within 85 meters, so I'm pretty sure they will be dying first. And then Alpha team will be dying because they will be conducting a diversionary attack, which means taking on a lot of enemy fire, which they are not equipped to handle, trust me. I've been working with them for quite some time now. And no matter who they defer to, Charlie team, it's always the same people. Incompetent. Anyway, moving on. Situation: coordinated resistance has collapsed. Enemy units in the field have ceased combat operations and are surrendering, except for this one base. There is one pocket of resistance left where the enemy leaders have gone to ground with their nuclear weapons. Okay. Our aerial reconnaissance shows that they are preparing to launch the weapons blind without regard to where they might land. This cannot be allowed to happen. I mean, like I said in the previous video, in most cases, they won't probably be landing somewhere problematic, but there's always a chance that they might land somewhere which is inhabited by humans or is otherwise, you know, an important government asset. And they would fill that area needlessly wherever it lands, unless it's in the ocean, which is the, you know, like the biggest chance of happening, which has the highest chance of happening. They, you know, will fill the area with nuclear radiation, which is bad for all living things there, most of them anyway. Surprisingly, we humans are the most sensitive to nuclear radiation. Most animals don't really get mutations that easily. They're like at least 10 times as good at us in absorbing radiation and living. I think it has got something to do with the fact that we don't have it for just a moment though, before we begin the mission. So yeah, let's go and get us.
Approach package with caution. It may be hot.
Roger, P6.
Bravo, we see two patrols in the valley.
Charlie, in position. We'll move on your signal.
Roger. Charlie. Good luck. Now, I do not want to give Charlie the signal because, well, I want to keep him safe. And I think there are two people in front of me, and I'm just gonna, I'm just gonna lay down on the ground here. Because apparently these guys have bullets that can penetrate the earth. So, yeah. Unwise to take them head on. At the same time, if you're lying on the ground, apparently they can't exactly just get up and start shooting. Either, so. Yeah, that's exactly what I was waiting for them to do. And what about you though? Aren't you gonna do it? Aren't you gonna follow your friend to the grave? Look at that guy, sneaking in the snow at that. I do not think I see any enemies right here. Oh, there you are. I was wondering where the enemy went. There was supposed to be an enemy right here. Excuse me. I hate those idiots. Shut up.
Charlie, in position. We'll move on your signal.
Are you there? Yes, thank you. Yeah, there you are. And, I almost finished this mission once, but now I'm getting taken out left and right, right on this location, and I'm basically being taken out by enemies who are not supposed to be able to take me out at all because they're hidden behind stuff, and their shots should not be able to hit me, but they are hitting me. So yeah, it's sad, basically. It's sad, sort of. Hilariously sad. Ouch. That one enemy down. Two enemy down. Three enemy down. Let me just go and cycle over to object Nova. There's the enemy that is shooting at me right now. Oh, there you are. Of course you are. Of course you are.
Alpha to King 6, we're meeting heavy contact!
No, you aren't. I took out most of the contact, enemy contact for you. And King 6 there is like, yeah, we know, no problem. You guys, you know, just keep doing whatever you pay to do. We'll take care of the rest. Like, zero fucks given. There's one more enemy over here, apparently. And I do not think there are more people over here that require beating, but yeah, just in case, there were. Apparently there was one more, but I took care of that guy. So there aren't any more over there at this point in time anyway. Somebody is in there who's trying really hard to kill someone, but missing pretty consistently. And that guy has also been taken out now. Somebody out there. Oh, that was Alpha 2.
Alpha 2 is hit! Alpha, I repeat, 2, Alpha 2 is hit!
Downright idiot. What made you so eager to go and die there? Like, seriously? Just when I was about to take a shot at him, this guy decides to go ahead and die. And who's shooting at me now? Probably those guys?
Yeah. Bravo. We see two patrols in the valley.
Roger, Charlie. I took out the barrels, but that doesn't really do much. The people who are behind barrels, they still don't die. Like, nearby the barrels, I mean. They pretty much continue to remain alive. Not a reliable way of killing anybody, really. Shot multiple times. Finally died. I don't know who Alpha has gone to engage, but Alpha, they better be worth it. I sincerely hope you're not just going into a death parade of yours. Marching to your death. Alpha 2, you shall be missed. Down. Neutralized. That is Alpha 1. Yeah, they're alive. That is good. That is really good to know that Alpha 1 is still alive. I think there's somebody behind this place, being the reason why Alpha 1 has decided to go ahead and lay down on the ground there. Cannot think of any other reason, really. Combined with the fact that nobody else is shooting them, I would say that they're probably in a very safe place. But I do hear other people here. But I don't know where they're shooting, like where these people are coming from. Anyway, should be a few enemies here, like this guy. And this guy, for this guy I'm just going to use a standard shoot grenade launcher. Not see anybody here. These two people I never understand why these four people never start shooting at me. But yeah, they don't. They just more or less just give me a free pass. There you are. I was wondering where you disappeared. I don't know what the deal with some of the AIs in this game is, but I think it's like a bug of their enhanced targeting feature, but yeah. They just decide to, well, start running for no reason. Like, just keep running around with headless chicken. And it can be funny to look at, but at the same time, oh, that was actually a human. I did not realize that. I was just shooting at it because it resembled a human, but I did not realize that was actually a human being. I think that is another, no, that is a chicken. Inside one of the vehicles there. And that is a person that I killed. That is a person that is running in front of the car thing. Oh, come on. I think I'm just aiming a little too high. If I start aiming a little lower, I should be fine. Let me start crossing over. Let me come back a little. And there should be a few more people up there that I should be able to neutralize from here itself. Now, who's shooting at me, I wonder? There you are. I was wondering whether there was somebody there or not. Turns out there was. What would you know? And who else is shooting at me? Is it somebody from inside that bunker over there? Oh, there you were. I see. I thought I already took care of everybody inside the bunker. All of a sudden it's quite silent. But I think the only person that I hear at this point is Alpha 2. Or rather Alpha 1 shooting at something. At an imaginary thing right there. That's another enemy down. Another enemy spotted right there. Glad for the extra round in the chamber. Excuse me, that should have killed you. Why did it not kill you? Good. I'll just keep moving along the ice here. If anybody tries to take a shot at me, I'll just hit the deck. And yeah, this is essentially how I did the first time around as well. Although I was a little more cautious, I would say. Like, I'm not being as cautious as I am. Oh, There's an enemy right there. And I think there's somebody else over there as well. Unless I have already eliminated them. Difficult to tell really in this game. Anyway, let me just keep moving. And somebody's still firing at me. I just can't figure out from where. The moment I do, I will give them a nice little present, a handmade one at that. Anyway, here's how you can exploit some of the angles to completely move to the outside of the objective. Now, there are two reasons why I'm getting some distance between me and the actual objective. One of the reasons is, there are actually three. The first, foremost reason is that the buildings in this game are bad. They make you bug out, so unless and until you can avoid it, better to stay as far away from them as possible. Somebody's still shooting, and I'm guessing it's that guy. Yeah, seemingly this area is clear. This building is still has a few people in it. I will be eliminating all the people there anyway. I'll be doing that shortly. But yeah, just for argument's sake, right now the line is clear. So just keep proceeding along this path here. Be not afraid. And yeah, do your best. I think I have eliminated most of the hostiles here, if not all of them. And you just need to be careful. Yeah, so the second reason being that at these ranges, it's difficult for the enemies to hit you. So even if you spot an enemy and the enemy simultaneously spots you, even if they shoot, they are more likely to miss than to actually hit you on the first time around, giving you a little bit of time to actually aim and take a proper shot. So I was actually right in front of that building right there. There's one person right at the bottom of the building and one person near the top, and the person near the top essentially just I was trying to take out the person at the bottom, but apparently there's a door in front of this hangar here, and the person inside just shot me. So yeah, that is something that you need to be careful of. And I think there, I still have not cleared this base out, because I think there's somebody still in there. They are, what I assume they are doing is trying to shoot me. I'm still going to proceed cautiously. We have now officially reached where Charlie is. That would be one of the terrorists there. You will get a shot on another one of the terrorists from this angle itself, and another one of the terrorists from this door. But as for the final one, you need to go to the front of the house and shoot them from there. So, like I said, if you are at a distance, it becomes very difficult for the enemy to realize where you are, making it far easier for you to shoot them dead instead of the other way around. Now, this guy, I was wondering where this guy is. I thought there was somebody around the corner, and there was. The completing this set guy, that is Charlie 1 and 2. And I don't know why they're there, because they were supposed to help me clear this base out, I think. And the rest of this map seems to be clear. Once I clear these two people out as well, it will be. Like, it will most definitely be clear. Just getting these two people, you know, engaging them is a little difficult. I think I managed to kill the father guy as well this time around. I think I did, but again, I'm not sure. Just keep shimmying along the edge until you see the enemy. Yeah, there he is. And there's just one last guy remaining at the very end of that hangar. You will not be able to see them from here. You're going to have to... go over to the other side if you want to see them. And you should be really careful in how you approach them, because they can easily spell your doom. I think I see an enemy engaging the target. Target down. hostile neutralized. Now, as for this guy, I'm just going to go ahead and use a grenade launcher. Reloading. That guy sounded surprised that he got a piece of grenade there. But yeah, whatever works for you, mate. As for this guy, yeah. The only thing that I can do at this point is simply try and eliminate these people without exposing myself too much. Hopefully the game does not freeze on me. You know, going through all these buildings like this. Proceed cautiously. Try not to get taken out of the game. And that's all you can do. Because this final area, it's very deceptive. It is very treacherous. Most chances are you will get taken out. I don't know whether that took out everybody in that room or not. I do not think it did, but just for argument's sake, considering that it might have, yeah, that is one less trouble to worry about. Now, what I'm going to do before I attempt taking that guy out is I'm going to try and find an angle on this guy and take him out first, because otherwise, yeah, it gets a little hectic. So to speak. Here, cannot see that guy from here. Cannot see anybody from here either. But from here, I should be able to make that guy out. The one inside this, you know, thing here anyway. See, it seems sealed. Like, I cannot see him. At all. Oh, wait, there's the entrance, okay. But you know what, I can actually just take this guy from here as well. Yeah, that guy's still not out, of course. I don't know why I was expecting anything different. Now, I just want to make sure that this guy does not see me before I see him. Because if that happens, it will be a tragic mistake. This guy is apparently right here, and he's somewhere back there. Okay, that's fine, that's cool. So basically I'm just stuck with this guy right here, and he should be somewhere over here then. Okay, that guy's been dealt with. Let me get out of this area before the game freezes again. Reloading. And apparently, since the guy is somewhere over here, that sort of tells me that maybe he's accessible through the back window here. Yep. And that's
Hold
it.
Let's positions. Just... Black Widow is inbound.
And let me just get out of this area first. I don't want the game freezing on me at this juncture. So with that, yeah, that's the end of the mission. And it was actually a pretty simple mission. Let me just go ahead and read the mission briefly before the game freezes. Yeah, 53 kills. Pretty sure, like, Alpha Team had a few kills of their own. And I think, yeah, there were like 3 more people inside the other building in the support base. That would put a total of 56 plus change, so maybe 58, 60 people in total on the map. So, excellent work, Bravo Team. The Nest Team House has secured the nuclear weapons and they are being sent to a facility in the US to be destroyed. Destroyed, huh? I see. Nest Team. I wonder what Nest Team is. Maybe something related to nuclear? But who knows. Spetsnaz forces have captured the enemy commanders and they are being sent to Moscow for trial. Additionally, our military forces have gained valuable experience in conducting air military operations. Sorry, in conducting military operations in Arctic conditions. Yeah, that's what I was saying at the beginning of this entire campaign, is that this is something that is better suited to you know, an Arctic commando rather than a special forces commando such as the Delta Force. But anyway, stay vigilant as there is no telling when your skills will be needed once more. Congratulations on a job well done. And with that, we are completely finished with the entire Novaya Zemlya campaign, or Novaya Zemlya campaign, I don't know how you say this, say this name, but yeah, furthermore, we are also finished with this game, and I enjoyed the game. I actually enjoyed playing this game. This game, even though it has, it's like fine milk, you know, unpasteurized milk, has its own charms, and despite all the bugs that this game has, and all the, you know, just sheer lack of level design, for the sake of a better term, a better way of putting it, it's enjoyable. It's actually quite enjoyable. I can see where this game was regarded as one of the best. Well, military simulation games of its time, and the game itself has more of a strategic approach to it than a tactical approach, because it's more about how you go around the map eliminating your targets rather than, you know, employing certain battlefield tactics to do it. So it's more about procedure and like that even reflects in the narrative of the game itself. Like every single campaign, the way you flush out your enemies and the way you procedurally, methodically weaken them, so that you can finally make the final assault on them and crush them, cripple them for good. So yeah, that reflects in the campaign as well. And I would say that the writing of the campaign is actually quite good. I mean, it's a very well-written campaign. Probably something that can be studied. If you want to have an understanding of how warfare is conducted. So, yeah, with that being said, I don't think I ever see myself be playing this game unless and until it's in a cooperative mode with some, you know, fellow players who are ready to tackle the campaign. So, yeah, this game was pretty enjoyable on all, and with that, we have officially captured the nukes and destroyed them in the US. So yeah, I suppose that's the end of a, well, comparatively long journey for a video game. I mean, back in 1998, for game made in 1998, it was actually quite long. I think I'm nearing about 33 hours of playtime as I, you know, finish this recording now. And yeah, I mean, modern games just don't give you that amount of, you know, playtime at all. So yeah, games back then used to be completely different things. So that's like, yeah, this is a product of its generation. As plain and simple as that. There's no other way of putting it. Thoroughly enjoyable, actually. I mean, despite the unfairness of the game and lack of technology and well, lack of a lot of things, to be honest, and the bugs to top that off, it was still thoroughly enjoyable in a very challenging sort of way. So yeah, thank you for sticking with me throughout this campaign, if you have stuck with me throughout this campaign, watching this to the end. And if you haven't, I can understand. I mean, this game isn't exactly meant for everybody, and I can understand, especially in this final campaign of Novaya Zemlya. Yeah, I wasn't exactly playing it in a very, how do I put it, flattering way either. I was playing very cautiously, and that's just how you have to play this entire campaign through and through. So, just one thing, I didn't expect the final mission to be a night raid, but apparently it was, so, oh well. This doesn't really matter to me in the end. Still don't understand why we were supplied with two laws for the final mission when the objective was not to destroy anything. And I completely forgot about not taking the laws and taking double load ammo instead as well. But oh well. What ends well is well, I suppose. So yeah. I will miss this game. But yeah, I don't think I will return to it. So yeah, once again, thank you so much for, you know, sticking with me throughout this entire game. And with this officially being out of the way, I will now be focusing on other games, perhaps a little bit of Daggerfall, and maybe some other game. Let's see if I can play two games concurrently, that is. So yeah, I don't know what I'll be playing after this at this point, but whatever it is, you guys will definitely know when I upload a video of it. And that being said, until then, well, take care. Farewell, fellow Earthlings. I cannot wait to see you guys again.